Now I want to consider one sum and its extensions for accounting of goodwill in case of change in profit sharing ratio. So where there is a reconstruction of a partnership firm, means existing partners change their profit sharing ratio, how the goodwill accounting is done, that I want to consider in this sum. In this sum, you are given the balance sheet value for goodwill. If there is an increase in that value, how should it be accounted for? And after the change in the profit sharing ratio, the entire goodwill is to be written off. How should we write the journal entry? This is one part. Again, second part. You are given a value of goodwill in the balance sheet. Before change in the profit sharing ratio, there is a decline in the value of goodwill. So goodwill has to be written off in the old profit sharing ratio. And after that, after change in the profit sharing ratio, partners decide to write off the entire amount of goodwill, how the journal entries gets recorded. These are the various points that I want to consider. For that, I am going to consider sums in sequence. Just observe. This is sum number 13. Its extension is sum number 15. Then same sum will be changed. This 120,000 will be changed. And it will be identified as sum number 15. And its extension is, see, if I change this, then there is sum number 14. Then its extension is sum number 16. Anyway, observe it. I read the sum for you. Kinjal, Kajal and Kamini are the partners of a partnership firm, sharing profits in the proportion of 4:4:2. The value of goodwill is disclosed 20,000 in their books. Partners have decided to change their profit sharing ratio to 4:3:3. At this time, during revaluation of goodwill, the value of goodwill is determined at 1,20,000. So book value was 20,000, determined value is 1,20,000. So there is an increase in value of goodwill. Past necessary journal entries to disclose the value of goodwill in the books. Now there are three partners, Kinjal, Kajal and Kamini. Their old profit sharing ratio is 4:4:2. You can say it to be 2:2:1 also, it is same. Their new profit sharing ratio is 4:3:3. So 4 by 10, 3 by 10, 3 by 10. Now balance sheet value of goodwill is 20,000. In adjustment, you are told that value is how much? 1,20,000. So book value 20,000, valuation made 1,20,000. What is the principle for its accounting? Goodwill is raised in old ratio and disclosed in the balance sheet. Because there is an increase in the value of goodwill, goodwill is raised. That too in which ratio? Old profit sharing ratio. So how much is the increase in value of goodwill? 1,20,000 is the determined value. Book value is how much? 20,000. Increase in value 1,00,000. Old ratio is 4:4:2. So goodwill will be raised in the ratio of 4:4:2. The accounting entry for that is goodwill account debit 1,00,000. 2. Kinjal capital account credit 1,00,000 into 4 by 10, 40,000. 2. Kajal capital account credit 1,00,000 into 4 by 10, 40,000. And Kamini's capital account credit 1,00,000 into 2 by 10, 20,000. This is how the journal entry for goodwill being raised is recorded. Now how will it appear in the balance sheet? It was 20,000. How much is the increase? 1 lakh. Now goodwill appears at 1,20,000. This is how the accounting entry is made for raising the goodwill in case of change in profit sharing ratio amongst continuing partners. Now, after this sub number 13, sub number 15, if partners decide to write off the value of goodwill after its revaluation. Now, partners, after change in the profit sharing ratio, they want to write off the goodwill. When they write off the goodwill, what is the effect? Observe it. I start with solution 15. After reconstructions means change in the profit sharing ratio means now new profit sharing ratio is operating, and after its operation started, partners decided to write off the total value of goodwill. So what is the adjustment? Partners decide to write off the goodwill after revaluation. That means write off the total value of goodwill. After reconstruction, when you write off the goodwill, you have to apply the new profit sharing ratio. And the new profit sharing ratio is 4:3:3. So, when you write off the goodwill, partner's capital account gets debited. So here, Kinjal capital account debit, 1,20,000 into 4 by 10. Kajal's capital account debit, 1,20,000 into 3 by 10. Kamini's capital account debit, 1,20,000 into 3 by 10. 2. Goodwill account credit, 1,20,000. How will it appear in the balance sheet? It was 1,20,000. We have a return of 1,20,000. So goodwill appears in the balance sheet nil, zero. This is how I have tried to solve sum number 13 and sum number 15. Goodwill is raised, then totally written off. Now, I want to go for alteration in this sum, that is sum number 14. Observe it. Here the change is 15,000. What was that in the previous sum? 1,20,000. Here what is the change? 15,000. This is a change. Otherwise, all other information is same in the sum. But I read for you. Kinjal, Kajal and Kamini are the partners of a partnership firm sharing profits and losses in the ratio of 4:4:2. The value of goodwill disclosed is 20,000. Partners have decided to change their profit sharing ratio to 4:3:3. At that time during valuation of goodwill, the value of goodwill is 15,000. So there is a decline in the value of goodwill. It was 20,000 in the books. Valuation made 15,000. Decrease in the value of goodwill. Now once again, their old sharing profit was 4:4:2. New sharing profit, how much? 4:3:3. Balance sheet value of goodwill is how much? 20,000. You are given in adjustment the value at what? 15,000. Now what's the accounting principle? Goodwill is written off into old ratio. In the previous situation, it was raised. Now it is written off in the old ratio and disclosed in the balance sheet. When you write off in the old ratio, partner's capital account gets debited and goodwill account gets credited. Let us work it out. Determined value of goodwill is 15,000. Book value is here given 20,000. Decrease in value of goodwill 5,000. Return off in the old ratio. When you write off, partner's capital account gets debited. Kinjal capital account debit 5,000 into 4 by 10. Kajal capital account debit 5,000 into 4 by 10. And Kamini's capital account debit 5,000 into 2 by 10. 2. Goodwill account credit 5,000. Here the goodwill is written off in the old ratio. Now how this, what is the effect of this entry on the reporting of goodwill? Just observe. It was 20,000, 5,000 written off. Now value appears in the balance sheet at 15,000. Now Look at sub number 16. Partners decide to write off the value of goodwill after its revaluation, after change in the profit sharing ratio. They want to write off the amount of goodwill. So this is a solution to sub number, not 15 but 16. After reconstruction, what's the adjustment given to you? Partners decide to write off the goodwill after revaluation. Now, write off the total goodwill that appears in the balance sheet, 15,000. When you write off, it should be in the new profit sharing ratio. When you write off the goodwill, partners' capital accounts are debited because it's a decline in value of asset identified as loss. Losses are debited to the partners' capital account. So Kinjal capital account debit 15,000 into 4/10. Kajal capital account debit 15,000 into 4/10. I'm sorry. It should be in the new ratio. 4/10, then 3/10. I'm sorry, it should be 3/10. 15,000 into 3/10, new profit sharing ratio. Cummins capital account debit 15,000 into 3/10. 2. Goodwill account credit 15,000. Now in a balance sheet, 15,000 minus amount written of 15,000. So goodwill appears in the balance sheet at zero level, nil. This is how the accounting for goodwill is done. What's the situation? Balance sheet value increase. Increase in old ratio. Then write off the total value. That writing off is to be done in the new ratio. The opposite situation. Book value of goodwill. Decline in a value of goodwill. Return off in the old ratio. Then write off once again. Then once again return off in the new ratio. This is the summary of this sum. I feel you have followed this sum. Thanks to all of you.